when you make a determination that propofol is the cause of death, you should know what the levels of propofol are and what they mean, correct?
Yes.
And when you make a determination that lorazepam is also a cause of the death, you should know what lorazepam levels mean, shouldn't you?
Yes.
And in this case, you don't know that, do you?
Objection misstates the testimony.
Overruled. You may answer.
Well, I think my testimony was that I'm not sure how we got to these particular numbers that the toxicologists found. However, having found the numbers that we did, I believe that these levels are the cause of death.
The levels are the cause of death, 2.6 and 0.169?
Primarily the 2.6. That would be the propofol.
Well, the 0.169 in relationship to causing a person to be in a highly sedated state, the 0.169 is much higher than 2.6 in propofol, isn't it?
Objection, irrelevant comparison.
Do you understand the question?
No.
Sustained.
Do you know that? Well, you reviewed Schaefer's report. Schaefer's report indicates a 0.19 level of lorazepam would put the person unresponsive to painful stimulus. You recall reading that?
Yes.
And we got a guy here, it's 0.169, which is about one pill beyond anesthetic for major surgery, lorazepam. Isn't that correct?
I'm not familiar with the use of lorazepam for major surgery.
Are you familiar with lorazepam being at a level where the person is not responsive to painful stimulus?
Yes.
That level is 0.19, correct?
Approximately, yes.
And if he wasn't responsible for painful stimulus, you could do anything to him you wanted, couldn't you?
I'm not sure that's true. I don't know that lorazepam would give you sufficient anesthesia to do surgery.
Well, if you use the term unresponsive to painful stimulus, that means the person's not going to feel it when you stick a knife in them, doesn't it?
That's true.
2.6 level of propofol. That is not the level unresponsive to painful stimulus, is it?
That is correct.
According to Schaefer's report, you got to go to 5.2, don't you?
Something like that.
Twice the level. Now, you were asked to assume that Dr. Murray was telling the truth with respect to a 10-milligram pill of Valium at 1 o'clock. Toxicology levels bear that out as being probable, don't they?
Toxicology is consistent with that, yes.
And Dr. Murray says he gave 2 milligrams of midazolam at 3, and he gave 2 milligrams at 7:30. And the toxicology levels bear that out, don't they?
Yes.
And if Dr. Murray's telling the truth and slowly infuses 25 milligrams of propofol, you wouldn't expect it to get anywhere near 2.6, would you?
Assuming that is all he infuses, yes.
And if Dr. Murray was telling the truth when he said he gave 2 milligrams of lorazepam at 2 and 2 milligrams of lorazepam at 5, according to Schaefer's report, you would expect about a 0.02 level of lorazepam, wouldn't you?
Yes.
So what we have here, we got more propofol, and we got a whole lot more lorazepam, don't we?
Section B.
Sustained.
In the bloodstream. Way more propofol. Well, actually, if the propofol, rather than being slowly infused over 3 to 5 minutes, was jammed all at once, you could get that point, that 2.6 level, couldn't you?
You might get it locally. I don't know if you would get it after everything had equilibrated.
You've got Dr. Schaefer's report in front of you?
I do not.
Do you have his diagram of a bolus infusion of 25 milligrams of propofol?
No.